What is going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's your boy Hunter X here, bringing us another episode of FTP Pyramids. Hope you're all having a fantastic day. With that being said, if you're new around here, click that subscribe button. I dare you, because we're trying to get to 250 subscribers. Let's get into today's episode. All right, last episode, we actually finally made the garden cloche, ladies and gent. Ladies and gentlemen, we finally got the garden cloche up and going, up and working. All right, one of the things that we are going to need, though, for sure, is I didn't get to make it in between episodes. However, we can make it right now. I don't see why not. You know, we've made like 20 of these already on camera. There we go. And then some of this. All right, what are we missing? Just some iron gears, it looks like, and some of this. All right, cool. This is going to basically gather water for our garden cloche, basically, is the gist of it. That, and then we need a bucket or two. Okay, why? Okay, hold on. Let me fix this. Because that's not supposed to be flowing there. But, you know. I'll put this there. And then let's grab a couple buckets of water. That should be really simple. 1, 2, 3, 4. We only need 4, right? Yeah, 4, because there's 4 corners. You, and then the guy in the corner. All right, perfect. That's gonna pick us up some water, which is gonna allow us to put water in the garden cloche, right? And then that's going to allow us to cook up our pumpkins, right? Because that's what we want. We want to cook up our pumpkins, ladies and gent. There we go. You're going to get water. You're going to get the pumpkin seeds. And you're going to start growing the pumpkins. In theory. I think. Maybe. I don't know. It should work. Yeah, oh, it's working. Look at that. We got a pumpkin. Awesome. Now, I gotta remember how this works. Tanya. Pumpkin. I'm pretty sure you put this on top of a iron bar? Or two? I don't remember. I think you do. I think you just do this. Not that. That, and then you do this. Yep, there we go. And then that spawns a blaze. Hold on, let me get a sword. Okay, he's being rude. There we go. There we go. No. Go that way. Alright, good. Did you not drop me a blaze rod? Oh no, you dropped me 10 blaze powder. That's a lot of blaze powder to be dropping, bro. Holy cow. Alright. Now, wait, what did I need? I was gonna use that to make blaze, right? Yeah, I was gonna use, okay, so we technically don't need the phantom face anymore. So, whatever we did at the end of last episode, basically useless. Basically. In a nutshell, it was useless. Alright. So, what is today's plans? That I have no idea. I have no idea what today's plans are. You know what? That technically wasn't a waste. Because we can technically still make a phantom face. I'd really like to use a phantom face. Here. Because I can... Oh, that's right. I need blaze powder to make the phantom connector. Right. And we needed... Yeah, that's a problem. Yeah, all these armors and things are a problem. I want to make sure I'm not deleting my clay tools or anything like that, nature. On accident. That's very bad. I didn't even realize that this was getting full. That was my bad. That was might be on my part. Let's toss all that in there. And let's get this baby cleaned up a little. Alright, well, we've got feathers. We started to get feathers. I can care less about any of these enchants. Or any of these thingies. I just want the drops. Like the ender pearls. Ooh. Okay. Well, I guess a lot of this other stuff is important as well. So, like, a lot of this stuff. You know what? This is what we're gonna do. We're gonna make drawers. Hold on. Let's try to make some drawers really quickly. To get this kind of somewhat under control. Right? Because right now it's just out of control. Drawers, please. Alright. We'll start off with 4. So, ender pearls, rotten flesh, arrows. Oh, bones and gunpowder. So, I need one more. One more drawer. Please. Alright, that is gonna get put here. Alright, gunpowder. You. Arrows. Why do you? Of course you gotta do me like that, right, game? It's like, why am I trying to eat this thing right now? Alright. I need you to be facing the right direction, please. And yeah, string. An experience. Yep, 2 more. String and experience are also things that we should storage drawer. And basically, then we're just gonna upgrade it. We're gonna make some upgrades. Basically void upgrades. Alright, I don't have enough obsidian for this. Alright, let's let it generate obsidian. Cause that's gonna take a minute. I don't know what I'm going to need more of. So for right now, I'm just going to put it on rotten flesh. And then what I'll do is transfer nodes, transfer pipes. I'm going to want another stack upgrade. Please and thank you. Alright, let's make sure that we get this taken care of. And I also want... I'm surprised I haven't made a key yet. Let's go to drawer. Because everything everything I'm ever going to need is going to be right here. And then let's get a key. And then... a controller. A controller. We had just enough resources for that. Check that out. Alright, I want to plop that there. That's what I was kind of afraid of. Hammer. I need more food, actually. To be fair, I don't need this platform anymore because I can technically fly. Ooh, this is gonna break. Right. That's gonna break if I don't filter it. I think that's where item ducts are gonna come in handy, actually. Instead, item ducts would probably be better in this scenario. If we were to use them. Right. Instead of using transfer nodes. And then you and then you go. And that's only gonna put stuff that belong in there. Good. My concern would be with the armor and things. But what can I do about that, you know? Nothing I can really do. Alright, well, we're gonna be getting Ender Pearls now. Alright, cool. Alright, so what's the plan for today's episode? You know what? I want to take this stuff and move it. I'm going to get rid of a lot of this. As I don't really need it right now. So we can go ahead and just throw it in the ME system. I'm gonna want furnace generators. How many of these do you think I should make? Let's go with a couple. I don't know how much a couple is. I'm gonna say like 8 should be more than enough. Like, more than enough. Because remember, I still gotta feed it charcoal. Right? And the way we're gonna do this is this. Actually, no. I'm gonna do it over here, and it's gonna be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, like that. We're gonna grab some leadstone. We're gonna need a lot more leadstone than that there, buddo. All right, grab some of that. That And then we can grab some item docks. Okay, how do I want to do this? Probably over the top. Hammer. This is probably the most stupidest idea I've ever had, but hey, it's gonna work. Trust me, it's gonna work. And then you. This will get us another quest complete over time. This piping. Look at this base technique. Seems legit. Alright. That's not working because we don't have a servo on it just yet. But that's fine. I'm actually probably gonna need that kiln back in a second, actually. Now that I think about it. Oh no, we've got some electrum in here. We're probably gonna need more at some point. This chest is strictly charcoal. So now that's dumping, or should be dumping into here. It's going somewhere. I wonder if it's because it's... It's in item ducts that are not impulsed, so they're not technically fast. Oh, we just got one stack. Yep, things are starting to come now. And now, that is just satisfying. You can just sit there and watch that go up all day. Literally. Just sit there and watch that go up all day. Now, what is that quest going to give us? That is going to give us the Amadron tablet. Alright, so the programmer. This guy right here. Oh, we're going to need... Yep. That's what I was afraid of. Having to make one of those. Okay. Fair enough. But everything else I feel like is done. Except for the one garden quest. Which we should honestly do. Right. It's not too difficult. We can probably do that in about, like, 2 seconds here. Right. We're just gonna hand in. Oh, wait. I actually don't need any of this. I just remembered something. Garden cloches, or when you make vacuum tubes, they... come with 4 or 3 or 4 or whatever the amount is. So we can go ahead and hand this in, which I believe this gets us cactus and canola seeds. Don't know why I would need those things. Why would I need these things, I wonder? That's what I wonder. Why would I need those? Alright. So, what is left? Well, the 50 bucks of Petrothium. The 50 buckets of Tectonic Petrothium. Which is that. Soft Clay Bedrock, or Clay Bedrock, which I believe you get from completing this quest. And to get Draconium, you need to complete this quest, which this quest needs a crap ton of Batania work. So like what I would do, what I'm probably gonna end up doing here is setting up or resetting up our Batania stuff. Right. Getting that reset back up. Okay, I'm probably gonna wanna actually switch this. So I'll have the Endo Flames sit in the back with the Mana Spreader. He will go there. He will go there. You will go here because I'm gonna put another block there. And then yeah, so that's how that's gonna work. So one of the forest. So let's rebind all of my flowers back to my thingy. Okay, and you get connected there. How are we doing over here in terms of stuff? Fullness. All right, we're doing all right. Ender pearls. We're doing all right on. Okay. We're at 1.8 million RF already. Yeah, that's gonna take a minute. With, what is this, 40 times 8? Yeah. We're doing about 320 RF per tick. All right. So what I'm probably gonna do is just grab a bunch of this charcoal. And make a stack of blocks. Drop it on the ground. Let these guys eat it. Let them eat it up. And start filling up our mana pool with mana. Right, because that black we won't be able to get that Black Order quest until we do this guy, and Tectonic Petrothium is kind of a pain unless we get the Amadron, which is actually funny enough comes from this quest right here. I wonder. I can use that to my advantage. I can use that to my advantage, actually. I can. Let me see. The culinary generator. Okay, not the uses, but the colon. Yeah, the usages. I want the usages. Apples generate 9,000. Mushroom stew, bread 24,000. Golden apples do so much, but apples are such a pain in the ass to get. Potatoes do 20, or yeah, that's pretty slow though. I mean, to be fair, I could probably get into solar at this point. I mean, you know, I'm gonna take advantage of this really quickly. I want a redstone furnace. I'm gonna use everything that I have to my ability. Like right now. We're gonna make a ton of glass. So that way we can make solar panels. Alright, so where's our next cable? There's a block there. Oh wow, we've got a ton of obsidian. Nice. Okay. I would like... Is there still a cable here? There isn't, but I can put one. Also, did I pick... Oh, did I not pick up the charcoal block? There's no way it's been 5 minutes. I was just about to say. There's no way it's been 5 minutes. Alright, you. Output on the top. Input on the left. Auto input. I want a chest. An iron chest. Alright, we're gonna automate glass really quickly. Or at least a ton of it. Like that many stacks should be good. Look at that. Look at how many stacks we have of glass in there, or are gonna have in there. Boom. Awesome. We are now making... How are we doing on power, by the way? We're doing just fine. Just fine. Is there a way I can, like, take advantage of wheat in any sort of way? I mean, cookies. But needs cocoa beans. Let's see what we can do for solars. This stuff does get expensive though. Quite quickly and very quickly. It gets stupid really quickly. All right, that's enough to make a tier 2. Which generates 8 RF per tick. It's not a lot, but it's something. Alright, and that only makes one? I need 4 of those? Oh. How bad are crafters to make? This is probably where I'm gonna want one of every circuit or one of each resource generator. That's already at 4 million. I mean, is there anything else that we can use? I mean, the frosty generator. Like I pointed out originally. This also does 40 RF per tick. But also... That is unlimited. All I need is to make a glacial precipitator. Which I can 100% do with no problem. It's super cheap. I can probably even get away with upgrading it a little bit. All right? We can get away with... There we go. You. A couple more copper gears. And glacial precipitator. We'll plop that guy here. He'll get water on the bottom. Now, before I get too crazy, we need ice for this. But what is the best one? So you'll get 1,600 RF every 2 seconds. You would think that packed ice would give you more RF in the first place, right? You would think that. Now, how many of these frosty generators do I want? I'm gonna say, let's go with 4 of them. Does that sound good? Hopefully that sounds good. And I'm gonna switch this over to packed ice. And yeah, we're definitely gonna wanna upgrade that bad boy. So I'm probably gonna want this back out again. Okay. Yeah, let's get this bad boy back out again. I mean, I could just make an induction smelter. That would work too, but ain't no one got time for that. Use what you already got. Right? Alright, I want 4 frosty generators. That's right. I said it. I want 4 frosty generators. I was just about to say, there's no way we're out of redstone. I've got like 9 stacks of it. And just to be sure, I'm gonna make sure that we don't run out of redstone, because that would be very bad. Give me 4 of these, please. I'm missing furnaces. And then frosty. Times 4. Item ducks, please. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, I will make sure. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Alright, one of these is doing it. It's that one. Okay. So, let's grab our whetstone. Our base is getting a little crazy, if I say so myself. Alright, let's go over here. Over here. There you go. Now our frosty generators are a part of the mix. Alright, I want this to be faster. So, I'm thinking kits. Now, I don't know if conversion kits are a thing in this pack. They look like to be a thing in this pack. I think the next tier needs hardened glass, doesn't it? Yeah, it does. And we can't make hardened glass at the moment, so... without taking up too much time. And also, like, it is wrapping up point, so... Alright, hopefully, yeah, let's also get an augment. Isn't there, like, a speed augment that we can throw in there as well? Yeah, this guy right here. Auxiliary out, put upgrade. So that's gonna make it even faster. Now it's using what, 60 RF per tick? It's pretty fast. We're generating quite a bit of RF here. We're adding 1600 to the network every few seconds, which is not too bad. But yeah, guys, unfortunately, it is time to wrap up today's episode of FTB Pyramids. If you guys did enjoy today's episode, please do me a huge favor. Smash the like button, smash the subscribe button, as we're trying to get to 250 subscribers. And also, ding dong that notification bell so you get notifications every single time the videos go live on the channel. As always, guys, thank you guys so much for watching. I'm going to love you. I'm going to leave you. Till next time.